Good morning. So an urban start to this one, which isn't that common for me. This is in Monmouth, just crossing the A40. Very busy, noisy. Very fast flowing water in the Wye this morning. And I'm gonna cross a bridge and then we'll explain a little bit about the short walk we're doing this morning. So up the straight road, and then you'll see a footpath up here, which is the Offas Dyke Path. I thank God to be off that road. Narrow little pavement there, and it was just lorry after lorry hammering down there. There's another one. Unbelievable. Highly unpleasant. Really, and cars ripping through there at speed. Don't know why there's so many lorries on that track, but anyway, we're off the road, so hopefully walk should start to get nicer now. Some signs following the Offas Dyke Path, some farms. This is a lot nicer. Away from, I couldn't believe the volume of traffic. That small road looks on the map like it just goes into the Forest of Dean, but I've seen busier roads in the city. It was absolutely mad. And the number of lorries is crazy. Anyway, the hill we're doing today is the Kymin, which is the forested hill in the Wye Valley that towers above Monmouth. I say towers above Monmouth. It's not a high hill, but there's a nice summit area where there's been some good views over the Black Mountains. So we're going to head up here. Gonna head through the wood and then round up to the top. I'll see you in a bit. So off the steep road. We've got Offas Dyke, Wysis Way, Offas Dyke to Thames Path. God, that's a long walk. No thanks. And Lower Wye Ramblers Booklet Walk 1. So certainly well signposted. Right, I'm gonna get up this hill and we'll see you in a minute. Right in the woods now. Very nice. Much more relaxing than earlier. Okay, it's getting quite muddy now. Had a lot of rain recently, so what's she seen? She's seen something down there, a squirrel or something. She's quick on her feet, it's old Maggie. Right, in a minute there should be a right hand turn that takes you up the hill to the summit. This is gorgeous woodland here, these towering pine trees. Wonderful. Anyway, the path we're taking is just through here, but lovely woodland, nice canopy. Well, again, this is gorgeous woodland, dead peaceful now, but they've served up the steepest bit of the hill to the end. There's a definite sharp sting in the tail here, but it's beautiful surroundings, lovely surroundings. So there's my path, some big rocks as well, and up this way. Maggie's found a friend to play with. To where the owner is, but this is so cool. It's like a valley of rocks. Cool valley of rocks. And there is the Kymin sign. This hill's got better and better the further I've climbed up. Really beautiful. Okay. Well, we've hit the hilltop, and this is the Kymin roundhouse, which is like a folly. I assume it's Victorian, might be Georgian. And there's some benches here. This is a nice summit area, quite a sort of touristy one. So we've got some treats for Maggie here, and we've got Earls, these are, so Aldi's finest dog biscuits. There you go. And I'll just guide you through the view in a second. The view is really, really spectacular. Honestly, didn't think it'd be this good. And we've come up a decent way. I think we must start there at near sea level. So we've climbed most of the way of the altitude. There's the big hills over by Pontypool. And you can see the ridge actually from Pontypool to, because you can walk that ridge to the Blorenge. Then you've got the Skirrid, Sugarloaf. Central Beacons, I can see, Tor of Vol and Talabont area in the distance. Wow. And then the Black Mountains as well. Pencerrig Kelk, Penmore. And I can see as far as Penygadiavawa. And even, I think, over towards Hay Bluff. Let's just come around this side. It's a shame because the camera won't pick it up too well. So I'll try and zoom in on the phone camera. So there's a gap in the trees here for the view, which I guess has been felled. Yeah, amazing. Hashrell Ridge. Really, really, really spectacular views. It's nice to look at the Black Mountains rather than me walking up them for a change. They're very scenic from afar. Right, I'll show you on the other camera. So this is the Naval Temple, which is interesting, built in 1800. To celebrate the noble admirals who distinguished themselves by glorious victories for England in wars past and present. So Hood, Howe, they're what, Duncan, they're ones I know. Don't know the top ones. Cornwallis, that's what a famous one as well. Yeah. Don't think Nelson's on there. No. Oh yeah, there you go, Nelson. There you go. He was the best of the best, wasn't he? So, here we go. It's quite a cool little folly. Britain's glory, it says. And there's a Britain with France, Holland, and Spanish flags cowering before the Union Jack with Britannia up there. Britannia rules the waves. It's not very fashionable, is it, to be patriotic anymore or to be proud of British past achievements? The woke people wouldn't really be happy with that temple, I don't think, but to be fair, we'd all be speaking French or Spanish if it wasn't for those brave people. So, there you go. We would certainly be invaded, and that's that. History doesn't lie, does it? Right. We're going to make our way down and we'll catch up with you in a bit. Nice views there into the Wye Valley, Forest of Deem. Yeah, nice. You see where, sorry, I'm eating a packet of crisps. You can see it where it's whizzing through there. Lovely. Nice open area. Yeah, that naval temple was built 1800. So Trafalgar was 1805, so built before that famous battle, probably Britain's greatest naval battle. Nelson obviously lost his life in that battle, made the ultimate sacrifice for the nation. So yeah, he certainly earned his place on that memorial, absolutely, as well as obviously Nelson's column in London. So anyway, that's enough about history for a bit. I do like history. It's fascinating, absolutely fascinating. So, I'll follow this down. We'll get just a couple more short sections towards the end. So at last we are Wye side. Very fast flowing water today. Really quick. Be fun canoeing down there. Just letting the current take you. had so much rain that I guess the river must be in spate. So it's just the Wye Valley walk just by Monmouth now. You can see the bridge just there, so it's not far. There you go. Beautiful. There's a whirlpools there as well. Lots of different currents. Very interesting currents. Yeah, amazing. Right. We'll do one more section before the end. We'll see you in a bit. So I'm really confused here, because the path is just gone. Just disappeared. And there's nothing. I'm assuming that the river is very full and has swamped the path. Which isn't great, because this means that... God, look at that whirlpool. This means that I'm going to be running quite late trying to get back home. And I'm on a time schedule, so I'm going to get in trouble. But Mark, White Explorer, will know if there's meant to be a path here. But it is just died. There's nothing. So I'm going to have to hurry back in the opposite direction. Yeah, not ideal. I swear on the OS map there's a path there. Anyway, we'll try and find another one. So back to Monmouth. I had to go back on the road as the path died. So hope you enjoyed that. Short walk, but pleasant. And took about 2 hours, just over 2 hours. They're very nice. Great views from the top. We'll see you next time.